Ever since we started doing some of our readings live from books, we've had so many people reach out and thank us. The concept of listening to someone read a book or read a story, it sounds so amateurish or childlike, right? But it's a beautiful way for human beings to connect through stories. I'm going to share an amazing story today about a great friend, Ray Higdon, someone who has overcome and did overcome so many huge financial challenges, limitations, and he's got a story that's mind-blowing. And as a storyteller myself, my favorite part of storytelling is telling other people's stories. Right? It's like it really is. In all of our books, we have story after story about clients and individuals. It could be celebrities, it could be authors, it might be musicians, but we have stories upon stories upon stories to excite you, to inspire you, to let you know that you too can overcome huge challenges. And the story I'm going to read today out of our book is about Ray Higdon and how he mastered the art of finances after huge challenges. I'm going to try to see if you can, there you go. Positive thinking will never change your life, but this book will. This is our first book that went number one 4 years ago. We have, what, 11 or 10 or 12 books out right now. And this one went number one, absolutely went number one. Thanks to Jenny McCarthy and to everyone who was ready to hear the truth about success. So I'm going to read Ray Higdon's story right now. And this is in his words that he wrote that we're sharing in this book, okay? And sit back and then when I'm done reading it, share this on your wall. Inspire other people that might be struggling financially, that there's a way out of financial struggle. And he's one of my favorite guys to talk about because it's such a profound turnaround. So let's get into Ray Higdon's story. Reach out and take action. And this is out of the book, Positive Thinking Will Never Change Your Life, in Ray Higdon's own words. Although I am a successful business person now, positive thinking did not get me here all the way. I'll share a little bit of my story about how I became a two-time best-selling author, built a multi-million dollar a year coaching and training business, and became the number one income earner in my last network marketing company. I'm going to share with you all of that, but I can tell you again, it wasn't all due to positive thinking. And this is an important point. You know, like so many teachers and authors out there say, if you just think positively, whatever you put out into the world must return in kind from your thought process. It's not true. And Ray just reiterated what we've been teaching since 1996. It takes a hell of a lot more than positive thinking to turn your finances around, right? Let me go back to Ray's story. As I was a real estate investor in the state of Florida from 2004 to 2008 and did, well, actually, some different partners and I moved a lot of properties. We actually owned quite a few different rental properties and things were rocking and rolling when the Florida real estate market was hot, I should say. When the market changed, I didn't know enough. I wasn't prepared and I was over leveraged. I got my teeth kicked in. I got beat up really bad. Not only did I lose multiple real estate investment properties, but I actually lost my own home due to personal foreclosure. From toward the end of 2008 through all of 2009, I was really in a tough financial spot. Just let me tell you what I did, and then I'll share with you what I didn't do. During those times, I was saying my affirmations, watching the movie The Secret, and reading different books on the law of attraction and things of that nature. I was constantly putting positive things on Facebook, even though I was in major, major trouble. You know, it's something that I look back on, and it's like I was trying to kid myself to success. Isn't that incredible, right? I can tell you it didn't work. It was interesting when my life finally turned around. It was July 15, 2009, and a friend of mine had invited me to a home opportunity meeting, which I was honest, I wasn't very excited about because I had already failed in network marketing quite a few times. When he invited me, I went there. My attitude was, what the hell? I got nothing to lose. So I went and I saw it as a vehicle. I said, you know what? I'm not getting any younger. Life hasn't been getting any better. It's been pretty terrible the last year and screw it. I know if I'm in personal foreclosure, I know I'm dead broke, but screw it. I'm going to make a run for this. And this is what we need to be looking at, right? This is the tips that from people that have overcome great challenges. We need to really listen to what they have to say and do what they've done. This is when I got into action. It is when I started doing the things that should lead to success. I started prospecting like crazy. I started reaching out to people that I knew, people that I didn't know. I started using Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, Twitter. I started doing the activities of reaching out to individuals, and that's what made a huge difference in my life, action. I actually went after 20 no's a day. Now imagine this, I went a year of just writing my affirmations and hoping things would get better, but really no action. I wasn't really taking any action. I wasn't reaching out to people. I wasn't picking up the phone. I was just visualizing in my foreclosed own house. So when I really started taking action, check out what happened. I wanted to prospect people, so I read this book called Go for No, which now I'm friends with the authors and they're amazing. I went for 20 no's a day. I wanted to reach out to people and get 20 people to tell me no to join my business every single day. I did that every day for 6 months. Here's what happened. I created this psychological trigger that said anytime I thought about how bad life was, I had to pick up the phone. I'd pick up the phone and I would call someone and I would say, hey, I'm running with this thing. You with me or not? I said things like that, but I was constantly reaching out to people, taking major action. Here were the results. Within 5 months of that decision, I was making over $10,000 a month. Within 7 months, I was at $40,000 a month. Within 10 months, I was at $50,000 a month. And that was back in 2010, and my income has never dipped since. You see, when we read these inspirational stories, people that I know that I've interviewed that have overcome huge challenges, it gives us all a chance to go ahead and to start to rock on our own. Now, the story I told today was Ray Higdon and all about finances, but you'll find the same stories in my book, Positive Thinking Will Never Change Your Life, about weight loss, about overcoming the loss of a loved one, the loss of a child. In other words, this book has really opened up the doors for people to see how do we move through major challenges in life. Now, I believe positive thinking holds the key to about 20% of our major success. Every day, I absolutely admit to commit an hour or more to positive thinking, gratitude writing, journaling, meditation, prayer, and more, visualization, right? I mean, we even have created visualization, meditation, audio programs to help people stay in alignment. I want you to take these messages and rock and roll. Share the story that I just read about Ray Higdon on your pages. Let people know that you can be down to zero. And if you have the right activities on a daily basis, walking into the uncomfortable, there aren't too many things that you cannot personally accomplish, and that's what I want for you. If I can help you out at all in any other way, grab a copy of the book, Positive Thinking Will Never Change Your Life. Go to our website, talkdavid.com. All kinds of free programs there to help inspire you to change, okay? So I'm David Essel. I'll come back and read more stories in the near future. Have an awesome day.